Pause. You can see this personality on the screen. She needs no introduction. She is Dr. Kiran. She has been selected as a role model by the Indian Menopausal Society. When we look at her, we never think of her age. For us, she is a symbol of strength, integrity, and the fitness of the Indian woman. Here she is seen giving out a message to masses of aging women that age is no bar for anything you want to achieve in your life. March 8, 2011, this is the 100th International Women's Day. On the eve of International Women's Day, we want to show that we care and we are ready to support those hands that held on to us and taught us to walk. With no government support system for the aging women and with family support system disintegrating because of nuclear families, the aging women have nowhere to look for support. So, they have to be fit enough to look after themselves. Let's add some new spice to their lives. As they say, spice hai, to life hai. So the today's topic, fit at 50, strong at 60, that is menopause. The word menopause comes from two Greek words. Meno means month and pauses means to halt. It is a permanent cessation of menstruation owing to loss of follicular activity of the ovaries. Follicular activity in the sense the ovaries stop producing any ova. Only a woman has the power to give birth to create another human being. Her body starts preparing for this important role when she is 12 or 13. Why menopause is so significant? Now, menopause is a marker of biological aging in women. Although menopause is a natural biological experience like puberty, menstruation, and birth, it is often poorly understood. Women are living longer today as compared to before, and about one third of a woman's life is spent in menopause. Now, menopause and emerging issues, what is the Indian scenario? Hormonal and behavioral changes that occur during this period lead to high demand for special health care. So far till today, women, Indian women never used to think of their menopausal age. It introduces a major change in the morbidity pattern, especially in the view of presence of osteoporosis, which is a disease of fragile bones, and increased risk of heart diseases and gynec cancer. The great Indian paradox, menopause and emerging issues. What are the menopausal issues in India? Low priority to menopause has prime focus is on maternal and child health. Further, unlike developed countries where women enter into menopause only in their 50s, Indian women experience it in their 40s itself. Large population of women from poor socioeconomic section reach menopause early compared with their other counterparts. Also, early childbearing women and women with no children reach menopause early. So friends, change is a part of life. Women have to be motivated to welcome the autumn of life gracefully and maintain the quality of life after menopause. Welcome autumn of life gracefully. These are the different stages in the woman's life. One is the puberty, then is the reproductive or the childbearing age group, and then finally the menopause. Now the woman inside the female reproductive system. So we have two hormones over here. One is the estrogen and the progesterone inside a woman's body. So why are they important? Because at menopause, the estrogen and progesterone level decreases, and this gives rise to the menopausal symptoms. Also, there is increased risk of fracture and heart disease. Now, when does menopause happen? Lot of women have doubts about the exact age. Am I in menopause or not? So, as per National Family Health Survey, this study is done in India. Menopause may happen any time between the age of 45 to 55 years. The average menopausal age in India is 44.3 years. 3.1% of women living in India become menopausal between the ages 30 and 34. 8% of women experience menopause by age 39, and 19% were menopausal by age 41. Now, what are the different symptoms of menopause? One is the uterine and genitourinary. By genitourinary, I mean all the urinary symptoms. One is cessation of menses or stoppage of menses. Second is irregular bleeding. Third is vaginal dryness. Then incontinence of urine. The woman cannot hold the urine for a long time. She feels like going more often. Then increased incidence of urinary tract infection. Then vasomotor symptoms like hot flushes, osteoporosis or a disease of fragile bones, cardiovascular diseases, that is heart disease, central nervous system, something which affects the brain, that is memory lapse. The woman cannot remember, she doesn't remember where she has kept the car keys, why she has opened the cupboard. Then depression, that nobody is there to look after me. Sleep disturbances, that I don't sleep too well at night, and mood swings. Medical disorders, age-related or aggravated by menopause. Now these are the seven menopausal dwarfs, that is itchy, pitchy, sweaty, bloaty, sleepy, forgetful and psycho. So these are all the symptoms which a menopausal woman experiences. Now we have to tell the woman that she is not alone. All these symptoms are common to most of the menopause women. Now coming to the stages of menopause, we have something called as a premenopause, perimenopause, menopause and postmenopause. In premenopause, the menses is regular, but the women may experience slight symptoms. In perimenopause, there are irregular menstrual cycle, plus she experiences a lot more symptoms. Menopause is when the menses have stopped for one whole year, and postmenopause is the subsequent years after menopause. Now a word about premature menopause. This is becoming quite common in our country, also termed as premature ovarian failure, characterized by cessation of menstruation before 40 years of age. The woman stops her menstruation before she is 40. Premature menopause is an important issue to be studied, mainly because menopause is the end of reproductive capacity or the childbearing capacity, and it is a beginning of aging among women. It is worthwhile to know magnitude of premature menopause in India. It is not something which is happening abroad. It is happening very much in India. For India as whole, it is seen that 3.1% of women in the age group 30 and 32 and 8% in the age group of 35 to 39 have already attended menopause. Further investigations are required to find out whether the occurrence of premature menopause is natural or induced. Natural is natural menopause, induced is taking any drugs or whether her uterus is removed. Then it increases the risk of ischemic heart disease and osteoporosis. The incidence worldwide of this in India is also very high, especially in our state of Andhra Pradesh. Proportion of people going for hysterectomy or removal of uterus for various reasons are on the rise. So here we see the different menopausal women. The highest is in Andhra Pradesh, followed by Bihar, Karnataka and Gujarat. Now what is the significance of premature ovarian failure or premature menopause? Such women have longer duration of exposure to menopause, leading to severe depression, mood swing, etc. than women who have undergone menopause naturally. Secondly, the reproductive health or the childbearing capacity. These women cannot conceive naturally, but thanks to test tube baby or assisted reproduction techniques, they can now get pregnant with donor egg, IVF, where the eggs are taken from some other lady who is the donor. We are having very good success in this area in our center. Then after menopause, be aware of osteoporosis and heart disease. This is a typical bone which has undergone osteoporosis. Bones become very hollow and thinned out. You can see the comparison. This is a normal bone and this is the osteoporotic bone. So 1 in 2 Indian women above the age of 55 suffer from osteoporosis. Now, why is osteoporosis important? Because the risk of fracture is very high. Even a casual slip or a fall may lead to fracture. That is, broken wrist interfere with daily life. She cannot carry on daily activities if her wrist is fractured. Secondly, broken hips cause permanent disability. Then 5 to 20% of women between the ages of 50 to 75 are associated with fracture of spine, that is the backbone, hip and wrist, due to osteoporosis. Getting short may be just the beginning. Bone becomes weak which leads to multiple breaks in the spine or the backbone. With gradual accumulation of these breaks, people get shorter, could lead to a curved back, which is commonly known as Dowager's hump. This is a Dowager's hump. Then menopause and muscles. So along with the bone, muscles are also equally important. Retaining muscles is an issue that needs to be tackled during menopause. If your daily intake of food is deficient in protein, you will end up losing muscles and you may not even realize it. Weakening of muscles comes to notice only when it manifests itself as either back, knee or shoulder pain. A good intake of protein, that is 1 gram protein per kilogram of body weight, will definitely help you smooth sail through your menopausal years. Now, menopause and bone health. A menopausal woman needs roughly 1300 to 1400 milligram of calcium daily. She should also consume at least 600 ml of milk a day and supplement the same with 500 milligram of calcium tablet to optimize the calcium availability. Ideally, calcium supplement should be combined with vitamin D3, as clinical report indicates a deficiency of this particular vitamin alongside with calcium. To make the bones absorb the mineral, you need to do weight-bearing exercises like walking, cycling, dancing and a sport. One can also opt for lightweight training, as that too not only helps bones but retains muscles also. Now, bone density, like how strong the bone is. How do we find out about that? So this is something called as bone density. Gives some clue about fracture risk. Does not take into account the energy absorption system. Methods of screening in women. So how do we find the strength of the bone? These are the various tests which we have to do. One is the dual energy X-ray absorptiometry. It is popularly known as the DEXA scan. And it is the gold standard in BMD measurement in case of osteoporosis. Next, we have the quantitative ultrasound using peripheral bone like the heel bone or the leg bone, that is tibia, or the patella, that is a kneecap or a finger, for measuring BMD. You must be very familiar with this because lots of BMD camps, general practitioners keep this BMD camps. You have a probe which they place it on the bone. And then we have the quantitative compound tomography. Now, DEXA scan, it is the most popular screening methods. Value below minus 1.5 is termed as osteopenia or the thinning of bones, and value below minus 2.5 standard deviation and below termed as osteoporosis, which definitely needs a more aggressive therapy. Now, why do we have to screen the people for bones? One, it helps decision making regarding hormonal therapy, what medicine to give to the patient and whom the medicine has to be given. Assess bone mass in high risk group. Serves a baseline to monitor or compare efficacy of treatment. So we do a scan before the treatment, we give some medication, and then again we do a bone density and see how much difference the therapy has done to the patient. Risk for subsequent fractures can be minimized. So if we find that the bone is weak, we can decrease the chances of fracture. Then there are certain biological markers, and these can be done by blood test. So today, what is the management of menopause? So how do we manage menopause? One is the lifestyle modification, which plays a major role. And secondly, the medical treatment options. A few tips to reduce hot flushes. This is one of the commonest symptoms of menopause. The lady feels very, she gets hot flushes once in a while. She feels tingling and numbness in the fingers and all that. And she finds heat intolerable. So wear cotton clothing rather than synthetic fibers, as cotton absorbs more moisture. Avoid hot and spicy food, caffeinated beverages, that is coffee, colas and hot drinks. Drink plenty of fluids, especially if the person sweats a lot, and exercise regularly. Try to relax. When hot flushes appears, try to cool down the body temperature with sprays or moist wipes or switch on the fan. Then coming to exercise, what are the benefits of exercise? A regular program of physical activity can help to manage many of the uncomfortable symptoms of menopause, as well as a related heart concern such as heart disease and osteoporosis. So first of all, the individual feels good. Secondly, it is good for osteoporosis. And third, it is good for heart disease as well, to prevent heart disease. Exercise also helps to reduce the depression and anxiety that often accompanies menopause. Aerobic exercise also promotes the loss of abdominal fat, which is very common in our women, the place most women more readily gain weight during menopause. Now, strength training helps stimulate bones to retain the minerals that keep them dense and strong, thus preventing the onset of and progression of osteoporosis. Reduction of hot flushes. Some research has found that exercise increases estrogen level naturally, which can decrease the severity of hot flushes. Along with all these effects, the person also feels good. Then coming to the diet. So lifestyle modification, the lady has to eat food which is rich in calcium, that is mainly milk and milk products, spinach, oranges, pulses and sprouts, and fish like sardines and salmons. Vitamin D, natural sources. Ours is a tropical country, we have sunlight most of the time, so exposure to sunlight. Food sources, that is oily fish or fish oils, butter, the yolk of eggs, and cereals which are fortified with vitamin D. What are the other dietary tips? That is salt restricted diet. She has to consume less salt in her diet. She has to cut down on sugar, reduce caffeine or alcohol, eat more fruits and vegetables, include lean protein in the diet, choose heart healthy fats, increase fiber and whole grain content of meals. Lifestyle changes, be physically active and fit, good thoughts and spiritual well-being, which is very important, and exercise.